Hello everyone, my name is Li Xiaohui. Nice to meet you. Oh, okay, let's start my presentation. My presentation title is A Comparative Study on Teachers' Narrative of School Curriculum Development in South Korea and China. We will first look the contents. It has four parts. One, introduction. Two, theoretical background. Three, a narrative analysis of teachers' school curriculum development in Korea and China. And the last is conclusion. Okay, let's see the part one introduction. First, introduction, the necessary and the purpose of research. For teachers around the world, the development of school curriculum is one of essential parts of the curriculum operation. It refers to the operation of making education curriculum documents that meet the actual conditions of the community, the needs of parents, and the characteristics of students in a series of activities in the school curriculum plan. Narrative research has researched documentation as a short able research method for study of human activities because the importance of narrative has been emphasized in understanding the experience that the teachers have experienced in running education curriculum or conducting development activities or at educational sites. Although Korea and China have a lot of exchanges in various fields, there have been few studies on the development of curriculum on the use of narrative as a paradigm. The fact led me to have a reflection, recognition on this issue. So this self-reflection becomes the starting point for a start. Okay, then we will see the research problem. It has three problems in this study. First, what are difficult Korean teachers feel in the process of developing school curriculum? The degree of state control and what are the expenses for curriculum development? Two, what are difficult Chinese teachers feel in the process of developing school curriculum? The degree of state control and what are the expectations for curriculum development. Three, what are the similarities and the difficulties between the narratives of Korean and Chinese teachers in the process of developing school curriculum? Okay, next is research method. In this study, I used a narrative inquiry method. Narrative inquiry method is the most appropriate method for empirical research. In this study, I invited three Korean teachers and three Chinese teachers were selected as participants. Okay, next is research procedure. In this study, the research procedure and the research results were divided based on the narrative inquiry process of Kennedy and Connolly in 2000. The research procedure is as follows. It have five steps. First, step one, exact in the field. Step two, move from field to field test. Step 3, configure field text. Step 4, from field text to research text. And step 5, configure study text. You can refer to the PPT for made details. Okay. Next, we will see the title collection. The title collection period for this study was conducted for a total of 4 weeks from 2019 November 7 to November 28. For this study, meetings were held with current teachers every Thursday before graduate school classes, and a video chat meeting with Chinese teachers were held every weekend, though the international after Chinese teachers build their works in schools. Next is data processing and analysis. In this study, Dingjin's triangulation method was used to enhance the validity and the reliability of the research results. The process of deriving research results is as follows. First, the intimacy rapport with the study participants was formed, and the purpose of the research was explained to the study participants. Second, research participants wrote a reflection generates. Researchers repeated collected the reflection generate writing, nominate similar topics, and create a meaning of experience theory among study participants. You can see the nominated preview topic have 4 topics. Okay, let's see the part 2. Part 2 is theoretical background. First, we will see characteristics of Chinese school curriculum development process. The school curriculum in China is as complex as the varieties of school systems in China's premier and secondary schools. Easy to see, we call it 6 and 3 school system or 9 years of consistency. Characteristics of China's school curriculum development process. Let's see this part. The characteristics of the school curriculum of elementary and middle schools in China are as follows. First, the curriculum has 3 categories: national, local, and school curriculum. Second, China also includes various activities other than regular classes in its curriculum. Third, vocation and level technology courses were included in the curriculum table. Fourth, it is necessary to adjust the weight of each subject. Next is characteristics of Korean school curriculum development processes. Korean's most recent public education curriculum. Now in Korean, 2050 curriculum. Is in Korean can the development of school curriculum in Korean can be seen as an effort to raise the level of operation of national level curriculum. The location of curriculum. You can see 2015 revised curriculum. Okay, next is the role of teachers in the development of school curriculum. In the implementation and the operation of the curriculum, the belief, thinking system, and the knowledge of teachers play an important role. Various factors, including personal, contextual, history, political, social, and empirical damages affect the formation of teacher knowledge. Clandy is especially enhances the history of one individual's experience. First, the personal knowledge of teacher is based on their experience as teachers. Second, teachers' personal knowledge is highly influenced because it is close to the emotion belief system. Third, the personal knowledge of teachers emphasizes active cooperation. Okay, let's see the next part. Three part is a narrative analysis of teachers' curriculum development in China and Korea. First, we will see the narrative features of teachers in China. One, the demand of professional knowledge of teachers in the development of school curriculum. The tendency to appear very high in conversation is that opportunities for continuous professional development at training seminars are limited to outside of school and in state council. In the course of school curriculum development, Chinese research participants differ in professional limits according to their teaching experience. For teachers, the quality of curriculum development varies depending on the level of knowledge and understanding of the teaching field and the level of proficiency in teaching results. Two, teachers' challenges on policy and implementation. Teachers may have the greatest challenge on the dictation and implementation of teachers' school curriculum development, as each school and office in which they work may differ in the declaration and the rules of education. Three, relations with teachers. For teachers, there are professional teachers who are passionate about their passion in the physical and passion and for education. Teachers who carry out their teaching professionals as a means of subsistence, teachers who are interested in promotion, and teachers who are not interested in promotion or who have given up at all. Their curriculum development and the operation are different. Four, the strong influences of the principal and the background of China's socialist state. Principles and unforeseeable leaders greatly influences the development and the operation of the curriculum. with a strong influence of the principal. Many teachers are influenced by his views. 5. Teachers' expectations for the development of school curriculum. The teachers include in this study regard it as a core expectation of providing opportunities for qualitative professional development. Okay, let's see the part two, the narratives of teachers in Korean. First, we will see the role of teachers in the development of school curriculum. Based on the development curriculum at the national and regional levels, teachers should take into account the human, mentoring, and developmental support that the school has, and actively participate in the development of the curriculum by influencing the leader's situation. 2. Difficulties in the development of school curriculum. Audits of schools have often been pointed out as a cause of unhappiness for teachers. It is recommended that the school self-assessment be made, but it is adjusted and tested according to this audit. 3. The degree of teachers' participant, cooperation, and an autonomous here and of consultation. There is still a school culture that doesn't actively participate in the development of school curriculum, thinking that it is the work of some teachers in charge. Although they are interested in school curriculum, they sometimes avoided participant in development due to lack of professional knowledge of the curriculum. Teacher cooperation can be done most effective when it becomes part of the school's rotation work. As a result, we need to develop a culture in which teachers cooperate as experts in schools. 4. Principal's leadership. If a principal has a firm education, philosophy, or vision of the principal who has a correct understanding of the school connected, the development of the school curriculum can encourage members to understand and participate in the development process together. It allows us to provide an advanced support for teachers away from the details, management, and supervision of principals. In this environment, there can be a growing sense of trust between the office leadership of the school and the teachers in the class. And the last is teachers' expectations for the development of school curriculum. It is expected that if teachers secure autonomic and avoid responsibility and based on the school curriculum, they will be able to participate in the development more activity and with fun. Okay, let's see the last part is conclusion. The following conclusions were drawn by collecting and analyzing the contents, the narrative inquiry result analysis. First, China has more to work on in that it needs to demand the development of school curriculum and the professionalism of teachers. Second, as a difficulty in developing school curriculum, Korea and China have different political and social backgrounds and face different problems because they are different due to various factors such as personal and contextual of teachers. Third, South Korea and China face the same difficulties regarding relationship with teachers. Fourth, in that it is the principles leadership, Korea and China have something in common that the principle determines the quality of running the school curriculum. And last is in terms of teachers' expectations in the development of school curriculum, the future of professional occupations of teachers and the teachers in closely linked to the future of schools. The education meaning and the significance of expense the stories of Korean and Chinese teachers related to the development of school curriculum in the rich process so far. First, Korea and China need to cultivate expertise as teachers. Second, it has an education meaning of education together in that it indirectly views that there was a limited to the development of school curricular by spreading difficulties in relations with teachers. Third, although national backgrounds and policies are different, it can be seen that it raises the importance of diversity education that respects differences as individual with individuals' characteristics and the developed needs of teachers under the common demands of the time. Lastly, in the field to curriculum research, it has educational significance in that it is not common to study the subject of teacher narrative in the development of school curriculum in Korea and China. Okay. Okay, thank you. Thank you for your attention. That's all for my presentations. Thank you.